Hi everyone, Carrie Christie here. The other day I actually ran across some video which I'd taken probably about 2 or 3 years ago, and what it was in regards to is putting this silver ring on the bottom of BB-8 or BB-9's head. You know, and they're essentially the exact same thing. So I ran across the video. It's not shot that great, but at least I took it. So what I'm going to try to do is put together some new stuff with some old stuff and actually make something that show you guys how to actually make this. It's a lot easier than you think it would be. So a couple things I know that I didn't videotape when I was putting it together is simple things like, what is the tape? And what the tape is just this stuff you can find at Home Depot. This one has lots of writing on it. It's just simply an aluminum tape. And if you get the one with writing, or if your only choice is the one with writing, simply use acetone. And the main thing is when you are prepping the tape, for lack of better words, put it down on a really flat surface and wipe it down with acetone and make sure that your surface is clean, because if you even have a tiniest bit of something underneath it and you're rubbing on it, what will happen is it will create bumps in the material, which will eventually show up on your ring. So there's that one. I also managed to find some that has no writing on it, which obviously be better. This is a little bit shinier. I don't know if you can see that. I think so. In the end, it really won't make a difference, but if you find one without writing, you're better off. So you're going to start the process by going through the lower ring, and at this point you have it painted whichever color you're doing. For instance, like BB-8 is generally white from this point here down and black from this point here up, and I used a flat black. Same thing with 9E, except for 9E is simply all glossy everywhere. So when you go through, the first thing you're going to have to do, which I'm not sure if I even mentioned in any of the videos, is you simply have to clean this surface really good before you put the paint on. And what I mean by clean it really good is not only wipe it down with like an alcohol wipe or something so you have good adhesion for the tape, but at the same time, make sure that you don't have any little bumps in the paint, hairs in the paint, anything like that. You need this to be as smooth as you can. Now understand, it's going to be covered. So you can go through it with, even though you've painted it, on these high surfaces, you could hit it with, you know, 400 grit sandpaper or something, just to make sure it's perfectly smooth. At that point, once you have it smooth, make sure you wipe it down, alcohol wipe or something else. I know I mentioned that already, but I'm going to mention it again because it really stinks to get this entire project done and have it fail because it starts lifting as it wasn't clean. So with that, we're going to go ahead and cut in a little bit of the video. What I will tell you that I didn't mention on the video is when you go to line to start this, when you're going to line that up, what you're going to want to do is typically if I look at some of this tape, there's one edge that is cruddier than the other. I'm not sure if I could see it on the video, but this edge is kind of beat up and this one's a lot cleaner. And that's simply because when I put the roll down in the toolbox, it sits on that edge all the time. So your good edge is the edge that you want to worry about. The other edge doesn't matter. So when you start the process, and you'll see it here in just a second on a clip, when you start the process, what I do is I take whatever my good edge is, and I look at the most visible edge for BB-8. So in this case, I always start with this lower, larger ring. And this edge right here, because you're looking down on the head, is going to be your most visible edge. So when you line up the tape, you're going to take your cleanest edge on this, and you're going to line it up with your most visible edge on here. And that way, when you look down on it, you have the best results possible. Because if this underside edge isn't 100% perfect, you'll never see it. You're staring down at BB-8, so it won't even matter. So with that, I'll cut to a little bit of the video. So for the tape, what you need to do is cut it about half lengthwise, and it just makes it a little bit easier to manage. As far as the total length, what you want is a little bit longer than between the two sets of indents on BB-8's head. That way you have some overlap, and it just gives you a little bit of room for play. So when you start putting the tape on, what you want to do is actually overlap one of the horizontal lines a tiny bit, maybe an inch or so. You'll go ahead and you'll place the sharp edge or the good edge of the tape against that one sharp, most visible edge of the dome. And what you'll do is you'll work your way along as you're putting the tape on, and you'll press it into place against the ring. Make sure that when you do it that you don't have any wrinkles or anything in there, because those will be extremely hard to remove later on. Go through, continue working along the sharp edge until you've gotten all the way beyond the next indent. At that point, go ahead and press everything into place, making sure it's nice and flat. So to trim off the extra tape along the bottom of that ring area, what you'll actually want to do is, or at least what I do, is I take my fingernail and I actually just press it and I run it along the edge. And after you go back and forth a few times, what you'll notice is that the aluminum tape will actually start to split. Continue doing that, and what I find is I get an extremely straight, sharp line right along the bottom of that lip with no extra aluminum left over. After you do that entire edge, then what you'll want to do is on the vertical lines, the short lines, you'll want to press your fingernail in there as well to go ahead and do the same separation. Once you have the tape, for lack of better words, broken all the way along, then you'll just simply peel it off. After you peel it off, make sure to press the aluminum piece in very well all the way along again, just to make sure nothing lifted when you peeled the extra tape off. So for all of the larger pieces along the silver ring, what we've had to do is more or less use a thicker piece that is slightly longer than each one of the little divisions, for lack of better words, the vertical divisions along his ring. For the upper piece, what you actually need to do is one long piece. So it's a little bit harder to work with, but it's definitely doable. So what I found is go ahead and cut a piece probably about a half an inch total width, but long enough so that way it wraps all the way around the ring, plus gives you a couple inches of excess, and that's a good point to start. So for this one, what I do is I figure out where the rear of the ring would be, and that's where I want to hide the seam. You don't want a seam sticking in the front. So I'll start at the rear, and at this point, it's a little bit flipped from the other piece that we did in that the nice, sharp, clean side of the aluminum tape will actually be facing the gap, which is facing the other piece of aluminum that you just put on. And the reason why is because the upper portion will go ahead and will fold over and fix into place later, so you don't need a sharp edge right there. So start at the rear, work your way around, take your time, press it into place, and then when you get all the way back around to the rear again, what you'll do is you'll go ahead and overlap the starting seam, and then you take a razor blade and cut it off clean. Next, I'll use the top of my fingernail, and working my way around the top of the silver ring, what I'll do is I'll press the aluminum tape into place using the top of my nail. And the object is to just simply get it as flat to the top of the removable ring as possible without actually breaking the aluminum at this point. And that's the reason why you want to use the top of your nail, or maybe a popsicle stick or something, as opposed to your fingernail tip, because your fingernail tip will split the aluminum. We don't want to do that. We just want to fold it over flat. After I have that flattened out, what I'll do is I'll take a razor blade and I'll trim it about an eighth of an inch in all the way around. Then after that, I'll go through and use my fingernail again to fully flatten it down. You want to get as flat as possible because the dome is actually going to sandwich against this. After you have the tape fully pressed into place, the last and final thing to do is to give it its texture. I simply do that by using 400 grit sandpaper. And what you want to do is, firstly, make sure you don't sand the paint. I've done that before. You can go ahead and coat it with blue tape, which would actually help out a lot. I simply forgot to do that for the video. But when you sand, sand in the direction that you want the grain to go, which is around the head. If you sand partly in one direction and then you change directions, you'll see it. Or if you tend to do a swirly motion, you'll see it. So try to keep the sandpaper as straight and uniform as you can, and just do a single stroke, lift the sandpaper up, go back, and do another stroke. Don't try to go back and forth, because I found that when you do this, you do get a little bit of a swirl at the end of each stroke. So that's all there is to doing BB-8 and BB-9's silver ring. If you like this video, do me a favor, hit the thumbs up icon. At the same time, if you'd like to see more videos and you'd like to get notifications when I release more videos, do me a favor and hit the subscribe button. Thanks a lot and have a good day.